So dear Ashish Tekwani, who has acquired an All India rank 74 in the entrance examination of PGI Chandigarh, being part of ISKCON and practicing spirituality, generally people think that such people can't make it in life. But how did you excel in both arenas of having a strong spiritual foundation and also excelling in your medical exams? Could you share your story with us?
This is the era, as we all know, of competitive exams. Success in any exam requires planning and hard work, but equally important is the ability to handle stress before and during those crucial 2 or 3 hours of the actual exam. Many hardworking students fail to get good ranks just because they are not adept in handling stress, in handling the tricks of the mind. And PGI Chandigarh exam, if I speak about it, it is particularly challenging. I have done my MBBS from Sage GS Medical College and KEM Hospital. So every year, it's like one or two students get selected in this particular exam. The format is such that although there are 250 questions in 3 hours, but there can be multiple correct answers to a single question. That's how it becomes challenging. For example, 250 questions with 1250 options, and we need to, it's like an OMR based exam, and we need to fill in 450 to 550 circles in those 3 hours. Better the accuracy, better the rank. Just try to imagine the situation. You are on for which you have prepared the exam, for which you have given so much time and energy. On the day you are with the paper, and there is like a lot of stress because of the fear of expectations and so on, and you need to recall everything in a very short span of time, and that too accurately. That's where the catch is. If you are too stressful, it will decrease your efficiency to recall. So this all translates into being able to handle the pressure of competition as well as expectations. Sometimes you yourself expect. Sometimes expectations of your loved ones, and in this regard, the most beautiful thing that happened in my life was to come in contact with the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, ISKCON, through His Grace Nandadulal Prabhu, who conducts weekly discourses based on the Bhagavad Gita in KEM Hospital. I was in second MBBS at that point of time. And initially, when one of my seniors, Dr. Vivek Mishra, who himself is a practicing dermatologist, who himself is a consultant in Bombay now, he introduced me to the weekly program of ISKCON. Also, I had so many doubts about the teachings, about everything, whether I'll be able to balance my academic and spiritual life. But in due course of time, all my doubts started getting resolved, and coming in contact with ISKCON, with devotees, helped me tremendously. For example, the daily chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, it helped me to better focus on my studies with more concentration, and I felt happier than before. And happiness within means efficiency without. Plus the teachings of the Bhagavad Gita, hearing about Lord Krishna, about the teachings of Lord Krishna, helped in sharpening my intelligence and power of discrimination. For example, I had learnt in the discourses that I used to hear in KEM hospital, the fighting spirit of Arjuna. So before the Kurukshetra war, Arjuna left no stone unturned. He practiced hard, he tried to acquire the best of weapons because he was a fighter. And at the same time, you have to give your efforts. And just the teaching, I distinctly remember one teaching that was spoken to me in these programs, the circle of influence and the circle of concern. Many times we enter the circle of concern. Oh, whether I'll be able to make it, what will my peers think of me, what will my parents think of me, and that's how our efficiency decreases. But I was advised to always remain in the circle of influence, to focus on what I can do about the problem I'm facing, rather than imagining some problems that may come, that may not come. So this again and again helped me, this teaching again and again helped me whenever I faced failures in my life. Association in form of the vibrant devotee community of ISKCON helped me enliven my spirits whenever I felt low. By coming in touch with devotees, I learned qualities like patience, compassion, which are necessary for any person who wants to give back something substantial to the society. And my counselor, His Grace Nandadulal Prabhu, was always there to guide me, to share his wisdom very open-heartedly, and he was always available whenever I needed him. And yeah, so basically there will always be crests and troughs in life. To sail through, you need guidance, inspiration and support, which I received from my counselor, from devotees and from the teachings of Lord Shri Krishna, and from the teachings of Lord Shri Krishna, which I got the opportunity to hear when I was in KEM hospital doing my MBBS.
I would like to ask you some questions. Generally, people say that to follow a spiritual practice during tough times or tight times,
yeah,
just before your exams or preparation, were you able to continue them or you had to halt them for some time?
No, I continued with them. In fact, that is the time where you need them the most. Because that was my nourishment. Quantity of studies definitely matters, but also but quality also matters, as in you are just sitting in the library or sitting in your room, but you are not able to grasp anything, that won't translate into a good rank. But you also need to plan, you also need to grasp whatever you are reading, and you also need to retain and recall. For all this, you need a clear intelligence, you need a peaceful mind to be able to think and go about it. So that was the time when my spiritual practices, which I learned from devotees, from my counselor, helped me the most. I continued with my daily chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. I continued with hearing about Lord Krishna. That was the driving force behind my efforts.
And could you also handle any failures because of your connection with ISKCON? Were there any failures in your life that?
Yes. Actually, when I was in my final year, my final MBBS in KEM hospital, so because of my own neglectful attitude towards my health, I fell ill, and that's how I couldn't clear these postgraduate entrance exams in the first attempt, because I just was not able to study. I had to concentrate on my health. Then I had to leave studies for almost like 1.5 years. When I resumed studies in March 2015, then in November 2015, the All India entrance exam, I had a lot of hopes that I'll fare well this time, but it was All India rank 5000 at that time, and even in AIIMS, it was in November AIIMS 2015, it was All India rank 2500. So I initially felt very disheartened, but as I said, I had been trained by devotees, I had been trained by my counselor in the teachings of the Bhagavad Gita, which are very, very practical, and because Bhagavad Gita was spoken just before the great battle of Kurukshetra, on the battlefield. For us also, the battles may vary, but each and every one of us has to face some battle or the other in life, maybe battling with the mind, maybe battling with the peers, and that's how spirituality comes to life. And thus I was very whenever I felt low, I used to talk to devotees, I used to talk to my counselor, and that always boosted my morale.
We also heard that you took a one year intense Vaishnava training.
Okay.
Residing at the temple.
Yes, yes.
Did that help in you anyway? Can you share some of the benefits of that?
Okay. Yeah. So that was like the first time I was living like in a community, in a group of 12 or 15 boys. So I learned values like cooperation. For example, in any corporate, in today's corporate culture, in any of the big institutes, what matters more is the teamwork. Because the goals are such that one person's efforts won't be able to achieve the collective good. For that, we need a team, and each one in the team has to play his part properly. That was one teaching I will carry with me for the rest of my life, and that was really, really very helpful. Staying in a community, tolerating differences, appreciating each other, and working together.
Thank you, Dr. Ashish Tekwani, for your kind time, for sharing some of the secrets of success in your life. And we hope all the best for your both career and your spiritual aspirations.
I would myself like to thank the whole community of International Society for Krishna Consciousness, ISKCON, and my counselor, His Grace Nandadulal Prabhu, for introducing me to the teachings of Lord Shri Krishna, which were propagated all over the world by the founder Acharya of ISKCON, His Divine Grace Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. And it has transformed my life for the better. I am really, really very grateful. Hare Krishna.